Good morning, Teliato in Italy and Meer Democratie in Germany. My name is Desiree Stoppel. It's 6 January 2015. I want to talk to you about the migrants problem. This is going to be a larger video and we are going into details. The International Criminal Court is growing in violence, and mainly from the Netherlands. It is mainly caused by the Dutch parliament. The Dutch parliament needs more violence via the International Criminal Court because the lies about the MH17 are about to be exposed. The lies is the truth I have been explaining to people since July 2014. The lies the Dutch parliament and royal family can no longer hide are diplomatic talks. For example, Dutch diplomats working in Kiev have been talking about fights, air crashes, war crashes, attacks, plane attacks above eastern Ukraine on 14 July. Thus, the Dutch parliament and the fake security lobby behind the International Criminal Court were informed about the danger you fly into when you send a passenger's plane over East Ukraine. It was only logic, especially from my world, that passenger planes would be shot down. There is something else going on, and that's highly significant. The army in Ukraine is a kind of holy organization. The parliament, the Kiev parliament, believes what the soldiers are telling. So all those yeah, it's too strange for words, it doesn't fit in our brain, but it's the truth. Thus, all the lies are about to be exposed, and for that reason the International Criminal Court needs to grow in violence. And that has a lot to do with migrants. We all know that the International Criminal Court in the past lobbied directly with the mafia. And the mafia organizes mass transports for human beings who pay 6,000 euro for a ticket overseas. So now we have those migrant boats. I strongly believe that the International Criminal Court is largely responsible, because the former register of ICC directly communicated with the Organization for Parliamentarians, and they talked about how to misuse ICC to create more corruption. And during those talks, mafia in tailored suit or in jeans and t-shirt were present. There was a mafia person, a mafia specialist on the Dutch TV who said, well, the Dutch are behind in knowledge. They don't know anything at all about mafia. And you must be aware of the fact that persons born in the Netherlands are members of the Italian mafia and human trafficking system too. So Italian specialists who are used to work in an anti-mafia situation for decades warned the Dutch, but the Dutch can't be warned for reason I have explained to you. What we see now is that Europe divides itself in two groups. One, the persons who are in favor of giving breakfast, education and jobs to the migrants, especially when they are from countries like Syria or Northern Africa. And there is another group who says, well, we don't want them because it's their own fault. I personally do belong to the group of people who say we don't need to have wars, asylum seekers, migrant boats, refugees on planet Earth. But I'm not going to the street to protest because that's useless. When the International Criminal Court and the United Nations would operate correctly, we would not have wars. We would not have migrants, and especially not human trafficking on such a large scale. You know, don't be surprised if the coming months we have 3, 4, 5 cargo ships loaded with migrants on the Mediterranean Sea. Don't be surprised if Italy and Greece turn mad due to an overload of migrants. I expect that to happen because I can follow the corruption stream from ICC, parliaments, NGOs, etc. The thing is that the International Criminal Court can stop all the wars, can stop all the migrants, but they don't want to. And how can it be stopped? Well, it's really up to the people. In the Netherlands, I'm going to write a new migration law. The Dutch title is Vreemdelingenwet. We have an old one out the year 2000. And next to the ICC corruption, it's madness. It's unreadable, it's a lie, it causes hell. So I'm going to write a new immigration law. The first article is about the definition of a refugee. In my world, when everybody lives legally correct, there are two types of refugees: economical refugees, political refugees. But here it comes. One can only be a political refugee when one has to, when one has tried in the homeland to start law cases against their own parliament, their own presidents, in their own national court systems based on human rights treaties. Thus, a person in Africa or the Middle East who claims to be a refugee has to prove that they have started law cases against their local government, against their parliament, their presidents, in their own court system, and that they must prove that they have made their president, etc., recognize the UN treaty and the human rights treaties. That's significant because the UN treaty is being misused to create war. When the United Nations would operate legally correct, a country in conflict or having a conflict with another country would turn to the International Court of Justice in The Hague. And only when law cases that spring from the United Nations General Assembly end up in the International Court of Justice and the court verdict is ineffective, those files can be transported to the United Nations Security Council. And then you can start to talk about tougher measurements. The situation today is that politicians all ignore their obligations and immediately start to talk about sanctions and military interventions, etc. They skip the International Court of Justice as a problem solver for normal intelligent people, and that's so wrong, because that's why we have more war than ever. That's why we have Boko Haram killing everybody. Only when the UN Security Council, after a court verdict of ICG fails and a country still refuses to build court systems, lawyers' offices, law education in the homeland, the International Criminal Court comes into the picture. When a country is a member of the Statute of Rome, the inhabitants of that country are legally obliged to make their president accept the UN Treaty and the International Court of Justice in their own Supreme Court of Constitutional Court at home. The people have to demand in court those law cases and those human rights. when the national court fails, like happens in, for example, Israel-Palestina, when we look at the borders drawn on the map, Palestina is officially a part of Israel, but in protest. The people of Palestina should be able to go to the Israeli Supreme Court, but they aren't. So that's a war crime on behalf of the Israeli people. They refuse to solve anything at all with normal civilized behavior. Well, when other persons in the same identical situation in Africa, the Middle East, can't go to a Supreme Court, they have the obligation to start a law case inside the International Court of Justice. International Criminal Court. Thus, everybody who can't go to the national court system must start a law case against their own country inside ICC. Only when a refugee can prove that they have tried all those law cases, or they have been boycotted, banned, they have unreadable court verdicts, they can label themselves being a political refugee. Thus, in my Dutch new migration law, a political refugee is a person who did everything possible in all the available court systems to turn the homeland into a fair state of law. And only when that fails, or when they can't go to ICC because the country is not a state member, they can call themselves political refugee and they can ask for asylum and they can be granted asylum. All the other persons who never went to court are economical refugees. I think that the people in Germany are too naive. I have noticed that there are many German persons who do not want World War II to repeat itself. And I understand the German fear. But both sides, the Pediga group and the anti-fascist group, do not work legally correct. And because they are all too lazy, it ends up in a kind of civil war. This is all due to legal laziness. The people in Germany need to become more down to earth. The people in the Netherlands need to become less antisocial and less psychopathic. The whole Wilders thing is a cover for murder organized by the parliament and the royal family. All politicians kill people in the Netherlands. All members of the royal family kill people in the Netherlands. We are a psychopathic parliament, psychopathic country. That's different than the culture in Germany, as I can view it via the media. It's different than the culture in Italy, where you have the mafia climate and master classes handling mafia. The people need to become less naïef, and I shall give you a Dutch example. Over the past months we have accepted asylum seekers from Syria. But when you pay close attention, you discover that those asylum seekers were the educated, well-paid inhabitants of Syria before the war. They work internationally in the raw material industry, the oil industry, etc., etc. So they have knowledge about handling European court systems, European contracts, and they really know how to take care of their business. What you see now in our refugee center is that those people have paid 6,000 euros to a human trafficker. They arrived in Europe by boat, and they have their self-pity story. I say self-pity because they misuse our system. What they want is to be patient and civilized in our asylum procedure in court. Then they want to study Dutch and they want to have a job. Ho, 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 ho. These persons could have started law cases against the President Assad regime in Syria to stop war. They never needed to start a revolution. They never needed to start a civil war because they were intelligently enough. They had the Western contract. They had the Western labor skills in the raw material and oil industry, but they never used it. So they started a war in their own country. That war is completely out of control. And now they decided, okay, we are wealthy, we are intelligent, and we are going to live in the asylum procedure in Europe. We will study the language, we will get a good job, and then one day we will travel back to our homeland. That is evil. And the thing is that it's very dangerous for Europe. The majority of the Europeans are asleep. They do not want to think and communicate like I do, because it's an awful lot of work and it's painful and you live in shit and you are being hated for it and being bullied and threatened with death. Yeah, but when we need more people who think like I do in order to stop the wars. The persons who are now the asylum seekers have created a war in their homeland first. Thus they have crossed that line of civilization. They were intelligent, they are intelligent, but they grew in violence. They have killed. I would kill when I live in Syria, if I have to make a choice. I would kill. I'm not a saint or so. When you have to kill, you have to kill. So, intelligently or not, they have killed. They're now here, claiming our jobs. They want the jobs normal Europeans have in the raw material industry or the oil industry abroad, the offshore world. And that's wrong. That's absolutely wrong, and that's going to cause a civil war-like thing. Especially when the people here in Europe discover that our economy will never be the same again. We will never go back to before 2008. We will never live in that FIP-like fantasy world again, because we have too much Al-Qaeda and too many lying politicians. Okay, it's 18 minutes. You know, people have to be aware of the difference between a political asylum seeker and an economical asylum seeker. And only when a person in their homeland has tried to go to court, can prove that the courts are corrupt, have tried to make their presidents and parliaments recognize the UN treaty, recognize the International Court of Justice, and they all failed, and they tried to go to the International Criminal Court and they failed, then they are political asylum seekers, and then they can get a permit to stay for about 5 years or so. They may never have get a real passport for a life in Europe. I leave you here. Goodbye.